Children, today we will begin with a new chapter, that is circulatory system. Now, do you know what is circulatory system? Because the substances inside the body have to be transported to different parts of the body, and this is the function of the circulatory system. And the circulatory system, what does it do? It transports nutrients. Nutrients like all the food which you consume, after digestion is transported to different parts of the body. Then respiratory gases, we have studied in the last chapter, oxygen and carbon dioxide. And all hormones, you know, are transported through blood. Then after digestion or other chemical reaction, the waste which are produced, they are also carried through blood. It also transports water, heat, hydrogen ions, and not only these are the things which are transported. It also helps in defense. It protects our body against infections by producing antibodies, and these antibodies are produced by lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are one type of white blood cells, and it also helps in maintaining the body temperature by distributing heat to different parts of the body. Now, what are the constituents of the circulatory system? We know it consists of your heart, then blood and blood vessels. Now let us study about blood. What is blood? Blood is a fluid connective tissue, and it helps in transportation of oxygen and carbon dioxide. We have nutrients and hormones, regulates body temperature, prevents body from infections, and clotting of blood prevents excessive blood loss. Now, what are the components of the blood? If you will see blood, it consists of two parts. Plasma and formed elements. Now, what is plasma? Plasma actually is the liquid part of the blood, and formed elements are the blood cells which are present in the blood. So, plasma, it's a yellow watery fluid and contains certain floating bodies called formed elements. What are formed elements? The blood cells. Red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Now, 55% of your blood is plasma, and 45% are your formed elements. So, now in 55% also the plasma part, 92% of plasma is water. And in plasma, 6 to 8% are proteins, and these proteins are like fibrinogens, globulins, and albumins. And only 1 to 2% of plasma is formed by food materials, the substances which are transported to the different parts of the body after digestion, like carbohydrates, proteins, fat, minerals. Then waste products also, dissolved gases, cholesterol, antibodies and enzymes, they constitute only 1 to 2% of the plasma part. They are all dissolved in plasma. Or it also contains electrolytes which help in maintaining the osmotic balance of the body. And there are different types of minerals also, like sodium, calcium, magnesium, bicarbonates and chloride ions. Now, what are the functions of plasma, children? First, because it carries the food materials after digestion, so it helps in transportation of food. And what are the food substances? They may be your carbohydrates. They may be in carbohydrates. When it is digested, it changes into simple form. So mostly it is glucose. Proteins all change into amino acids. Then it may be vitamins, minerals, and all the fat change into fatty acids. So by blood, they are transported to the different cells of the body. Then it transports waste products. All the metabolic waste of nitrogen, they are mostly urea, uric acid, ammonia, creatinine, they are also transported through plasma. then they are taken to the kidney, and from kidney they are excreted outside the body. It transports carbon dioxide, it transports oxygen, hormones, all are transported by blood. It also helps in maintaining the water balance, pH of the body also. It also helps in maintaining your body temperature. And again, same points are there, provides immunity by antibodies which are present in the plasma. And proteins like globulins, what is their function? They make antibodies, so they help in defense. Albumins help in maintaining the water balance of the body, that is known as osmotic balance. Because between the intercellular fluid and in the cells, the main water balance should be there, otherwise water from one side will go to another side by endosmosis or exosmosis. And then fibrinogens are there which help in clotting of blood, and they prevent blood loss whenever there is an injury. So there are three types of proteins: globulins, which help in making antibodies; albumins, which help in maintaining the water balance, or we also call it osmotic balance; and fibrinogens, which help in clotting of blood. Now let us study about formed elements. Formed elements are how much? 45% of the blood are formed elements. They are your red blood cells, we also call them erythrocytes. White blood cells, we call it leuco. Leuco means white, cytes means cells. Erythro means red, cytes means cells and platelets. Thrombocytes, thrombin is the clot which they make in cells. So platelets are cells which form clots. Now let us study about red blood cells. You may have studied in class 10 also. Main thing, they contain a red colored pigment known as hemoglobin. And what is the function of hemoglobin? To transport oxygen to different parts of the body in the form of oxyhemoglobin. Now what is the shape? They are circular, biconcave and disc-shaped. And due to this, it increases their surface area to carry maximum amount of oxygen, 20 to 30%. Children, these cells are devoid of nucleus, they do not have mitochondria, they do not have cell organelles. Only that they may carry maximum amount of oxygen to the different parts of the body. And they are in a very large number, 4.5 to 5 million per cubic millimeter. You know what is 1 cubic millimeter? 1 millimeter is so small. So about one drop. And in that, how much? 4.5 to 5 million RBCs are present. They are devoid of nucleus, means they do not contain nucleus also. And where are they produced? All the blood cells are mostly produced in the bone marrow. Where is bone marrow? Bone marrow is the hollow part of the long bones of the body. Now, and their lifespan is 120 days, and after that again new blood cells are formed. And main thing is they help in transportation of respiratory gas, oxygen in the form of oxyhemoglobin, and carbon dioxide in the form of carbaminohemoglobin. And after their lifespan is over, they are destroyed in the spleen. What is their function? Main function is transportation of respiratory gases. Now, white blood cells. White blood cells, we also call them leukocytes. So, leuco means colorless. So, mostly they are without any color because they do not contain hemoglobin. And see, these are the cells which are amoeboid. Amoeboid means without a definite shape. And why do they have this shape? Because they can move from the capillaries easily to the site of infection by changing their shape. And this movement is known as amoeboid movement. Size is about 12 to 20 micrometers. They are a little larger than RBCs. And their number is from 6,000 to 8,000 per cubic millimeter. See the difference. RBCs were 4.5 to 5 million. and they are only 6 to 8,000 per cubic millimeter. Lifespan is also very short, about 3 to 4 days, and they are nucleated. So like this you can see the differences also. If you read both of them together, you can know what are the differences. And what is their function? They protect the body against infections by producing antibodies. And some of them are phagocytic in nature. Phagocytic means they capture the pathogens and kill them. And these white blood cells are of two types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Now, what are granulocytes? Those white blood cells which contain granules in their cytoplasm. And they have multinucleated nucleus. Nucleus contains with many lobes. So we call it polymorphic nucleus. And they are main, so main characteristics are granular cytoplasm and polymorphic nucleus. And they are of how many types? Three types: neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils. Now what is the function of neutrophils? They are phagocytic and protect against infections. Phagocytic means those who engulf the pathogen. So they kill the germs, and they are about 62% of the white blood cells. 62% are neutrophils, so they are very important to protect our bodies by capturing the pathogens and engulfing them. Now eosinophils, what is their? They are slightly phagocytic, but their main function is they have a role in the allergic reactions. Allergy we have studied in the last chapter, when pollen or dust, some people are allergic to that. So they have a role in allergic reaction, and their amount is also very less, about 2 to 3% of the white blood cells. And third is your basophils. Their main role is in inflammatory reaction. When there is any infection occurs, inflammation means swelling. They produce swelling in that portion in which the white blood cells come and try to capture the pathogen and try to remove them from that part. So main function is in inflammatory reactions of basophils. And they are 0.5 to 1%. See, eosinophils are